On today's episode of Bus Guides, we'll be studying bus shifts. As this might be the favorite topic amongst bus enthusiasts and also the members of the public, especially those who are keen in joining the bus industry. As we all know, buses in Singapore will run up to 20 hours a day based on full day shift driven by two different bus captains under shifts. But what are the types of shifts that are applied in the bus industry for buses and bus captains? Let us explain. There are 6 shifts in total, which is the AM shift, PM shift, but for those full day bus may refer to as AP shift, but were split into 2 different bus captains in those shifts that as mentioned, S1, S2, or E, DQ, and night. Different bus operators have different names to refer, but it's the same operation. So let's get into the each meaning of the shifts. AM shift. AM shift are mainly bus captains just in the morning shift, mainly have to be in depot between 4 a.m. and end trip around 3 p.m. depends on the slot roster that the starter had prepared for you. It may be start early or late, and earlier or later. Mainly it involves the first few buses from the interchanges terminals or halfway departure. It also involves in the morning peak rush and lunchtime. The bus captain will then end his or her shift at the bus interchange that was been given by the time card to know where is the bus captain and their shift or bring the bus back to the depot. Next, PM shift. PM shifts are mainly bus captains driving in the afternoon and evening. It also involves evening peak and perform last few buses from the interchange. It usually start around 2 p.m. and end shift at least before 2 a.m. But as what we've been told, the earlier you start, the earlier you end. The later you start, the later you end. Sometimes can be the other way around. For this, you can collect the bus at the bus interchange where you rotate the bus from your AM shift colleagues or collect the bus from the depot. However, you have to end your shift by returning the bus back to the depot at the end of the day. Next, S1 shift. S refers to split, in this case, mainly called split shift. Split shift focusing on the peak hours. Not only adding more buses in peak hours, split shifts also involves covering the meal break duty for AM and PM shift even after peak hours by 1 or 2 trips at least. In between the off-peak, split shift bus captains were needed to go back to the depot and have a very long rest before continuing the peak hour hassle. At all times, you have to report it to the depot before your duty starts, during your break, and after your shift. Next, S2 or extend shift. Similar to S1 for morning peak, S2 ends its morning part of the shift a bit later. Why? Some AM shift, their meal break will be at later timing between 9 a.m. to 11 a.m. So, S2 shifts in the morning is not only to support the morning peak nonsense, but to cover the meal breaks for the AM shift bus captain. Also the same as S1, where you need to report in the depot as always, S2 were to start a bit early in the afternoon, roughly between 12 p.m. and ends around between 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. depends on the duty that was given. To some bus services, the routes were needed to support the deployment because it also passes by plenty of primary and secondary schools. Hence, S2 shifts were also to be adding more buses to make it shorter waiting time. Unlike S1, S2 gets an additional meal break in the afternoon. Next, TQ or third quarter shift. Again, TQ have to be reported to be in the depot before and after the shift. In this case, is a majority on weekends. As much shifts were less seen on weekends where there are more AP shifts. Not only that, it also to support the demand in the daytime. Hence, the 3Q shifts is more to cover the meal break for AM and PM shifts throughout the day, where 3Q shifts have lunch break and a short coffee break around 3 PM plus. Usually it starts between 7 AM to 8 AM and ends around 6 PM to 8 PM. Last but not least, night shift. Night shift were usually applied to night rider and night hour bus services and workers transport. The usual night shift duration, just like in any other sector. Majority, it only applies for ferrying staff ferrying back and forth the depot and their respective homes on the fixed route. Now, we sure all of you heard of interlining or crossovers. So what does it mean? Interlining means that a bus duty roster involved in interlining have to do 2 to 3 bus services in one single duty roster. Bus captain may not or may need to jump bus, which we will explain to that later. If let's say a bus captain is driving service 119 as the main duty roster, which involves service 34, he need to drive service 34 for a usual for a trip or two before continue to drive service 119 as usual. Interlining mob mainly practiced in during peak hours, where it will cross to bus services that needed to add due to the demand. Subsequently, in the off-peak, where it crosses to other bus services that can cover the meal break, or to another bus services that need high demand in the evening. We mentioned jump bus earlier on. Jump bus refers to a bus captain that was given a roster, have to rotate bus in a single roster. This might be involved with interlining, where bus captain switch to a different bus to drive a particular bus services according to the roster. Or, the bus captain have to rotate different bus in the single bus service throughout their duty. For example, this jump bus often to go hit Punggol feeder service. What are the mishaps that the locals are not suitable to be driving behind the wheel with such long hours? All of the answers are there in the episode hashtag debate. Thank you for tuning in to this week's episode of Bus Guides. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And I'm